Hello everyone, in this video we will learn class 7 grammar magic chapter 6 future tense revision. This is part 2. Here we will solve exercise D, E, F. But before we solve exercise, we need to understand some of the examples which is displayed on the screen. We need to understand present continuous, that is SMR plus ing, and simple present tense verb form, that is v1 or v1 plus s or es. So actually these verb forms, as you can see here, am going, and here you can see leaves. So am going is the present continuous tense verb form and leaves is the simple present tense verb form. So they can be also used sometimes to indicate future. Yes, so let's understand it with the help of this conversation between Mahesh and his friend Ismail. Mahesh said, "Hi Ismail, how are you?" Ismail replied, "Oh fine, I'm going to America in a week." Mahesh asked, "Is that so? What will you be doing there?" Ismail replied, "I'm going to study medicine in the university there. I'll be staying with my aunt in New York. I have already booked my tickets. My plane leaves on Wednesday." See, whenever the fixed timing is given, so we can just use simple present tense. "Well, good luck, dear friend," Ismail said. "Thanks." So here you can see that we can use present continuous tense in place of going to form, okay, to indicate the future. And however, when we use the present continuous tense, there is a suggestion that an arrangement has already been done. Okay, this is what we are just using to show that the arrangement is already been done. Means ki aunt ke saath rahunga, theek hai, ye karunga, main ye jaunga, ye karunga, padhne ke liye main jane wala hu. To ye sari arrangement is already done. And when we use simple present tense, that means we are talking about events in future which occur at a specific time. Here specific time is Wednesday. So keeping this thing in your mind, we have to solve next exercise. Okay, now let's understand future continuous tense. The difference between present continuous, that is SMR going to plus V1, is different, and the future continuous tense in which we use the verb form will be shall be plus ing. So look at this sentence is, "I'll be watching the cricket match on television when she arrives tonight." Okay, arrives tonight. So tonight is the specific time in future. We have used simple present tense here. "The conductor will be selling the tickets when the bus is in motion." So here also is given, that shows simple present tense. Then next example is, "He'll be studying at the library tonight." So all the highlighted words "will be watching," "will be selling," "will be studying" are in future continuous tense. "Will be" shows future tense, and V1 plus ing shows continuity. So the future continuous tense is used for an action that will go on for some time in future. So when I will watch the cricket match, obviously it would be of minimum 3 to 4 hours, okay? And when the conductor will sell the tickets, it will also go on for some, at least few minutes. And when he'll be studying at the library, it will be also, of course, 1 hour or more than that. So when the action will be going on for some time in the future, so it is used, we just use future continuous tense, and it is used to talk about events that are expected to happen in the future. Okay, they are expected to happen. So in this exercise we will solve the conversation between Sandhya and Mohit with the help of simple future or future continuous. So simple future means will shall plus V1, and future continuous means will be shall be plus ing. So Sandhya and Mohit are talking here. Where is Tarun going to meet us? So Mohit says, he dash for us till our train arrives. So we can say he will wait for us. I'm sure he dash on the platform when we reach the station. So when we will reach at that time, which action will be going on? Tarun's standing. Okay, so we can say that he will be standing on platform when we reach there. Sandhya asked, and then what? Mohit said, we dash Minal from her school. So we will pick Minal from her school and go out for lunch. Go out her lunch. See, it is for, not her, okay? And the other thing, how can we come to know that here we have to use will pick? So when and is used, so before and after and, whichever verbs are used, they both should be in the same tense. So here go is used. That means we have used will shall before that. Okay. So when the common verbs are used, we just write it in the first blank. That means will is common for both pick and go. So we have used will here only. So यहाँ पे आप लोग will को repeat नहीं करोगे. You will write only this second verb, that is go. So we will pick Minal from her and go out for lunch. And the second thing is that this action will not be continued for some time. Okay, pick up करने में ज़्यादा देर नहीं लगती है. So we can say that here we have to use simple future tense, that is will shall plus V1. Next conversation is of Taksh and Arnav. Taksh asked, when we get to the party, Jeevan will be watching television, Sujata will be cooking food, and Brinda will be dancing by herself, and Siddharth will be complaining about his day at work. So all this action, Jeevan's watching television, Sujata's cooking food, Brinda's dancing, and Siddharth's complaining about his day. Everything would be going on for some time. They might be busy with these actions when we will go there. So that's why we have used future continuous tense will be plus ing. Next, Arnav said, maybe this time they won't be doing the same things. Taksh said, I am absolutely positive. They will be doing the same things. They always do the same things. Okay? मुझे पता है कि वो ऐसा ही करते होंगे कि हर बार वो ऐसा ही करते हैं. So they will be doing, because see, in watching television, in cooking food, in dancing and in complaining about something, we just need at least some time. So these actions go on for at least few minutes. So we can just say that it is used in future continuous tense. Now after that, we need to understand future perfect tense. This entire chapter is about future tense, but future tense is divided into four different category: simple, continuous, or you can say progressive, perfect, then perfect continuous. So here we have seen simple future and future continuous. So this is the third thing we have to see, future perfect tense. Now future means bhavishya, okay, and perfect means the completed action. So here in such sentences, we just use future perfect tense when we wish to say that something or some action will be over at a given point of time in future. For example, they will have reached the station by evening. So by this time in future, this action would have been done. Okay, so for future tense we are using will, for perfect we are using have and V3. Okay, we always use V3 form in perfect tenses, and as it is future, we are using will have. With auxiliary we always use have. Okay, and will Arun have received the parcel by Sunday? So by Sunday it is the future time. Okay, till this time will this action be over, means अरुण के ये रिसीव करने की एक्शन ओवर हो चुकी होगी. सो हियर यू कैन सी दिस विल हैव एन वी थ्री इन बोथ द एग्जाम्पल्स. ऑलराइट, नाउ फॉर्म ऑफ द फ्यूचर परफेक्ट टेंस एज वी हैव सीन दैट विल शैल हैव एंड पार्टिसिपल ऑफ द वर्ब दैट मीन्स पास्ट पार्टिसिपल वी थ्री फॉर्म. मधुर शैल हैव फिनिश्ड हिज म्यूजिक लेसन by 7 p.m. when we are definitely we are sure that it is going to be happened, so we can use vice versa also. Otherwise with I and we generally we use shall according to grammar rules, and with other pronouns and nouns we use will, but here madhur means he. Even then we have used shall here because it is going to happen for sure. So the action which is certainly is going to happen, so for that we can use the shall and will, vice versa. The river will have overflown in July. Now exercise E, we have to fill in the blanks using the future perfect tense. Okay, so future perfect tense means will or shall plus have plus v3. So shift, finish, deliver, read, all this converted will into V3, and before that we'll be using will have or shall have. So by the month end, I will have shifted to another city, or you can say I shall have shifted to another city, means by the end of this month, this action of shifting will have been done, will have been over. Next is I dash finish writing the book by the end of this year. So I shall have finished or I will have finished. So this is the future time. Okay, by the end of this year, till this time, this action would have been done. The headmaster will have delivered the speech before I reach the stage. Then by the time her flight lands, Paulina will have read the magazine. So Paulina must have bought a magazine, and पूरी सफ़र के दौरान शी माइट बी गोइंग टू रीड द नॉवेल मैगजीन. सो इट इज़ जस्ट एज पर पॉलिनाज यू नो स्पीड ऑफ रीडिंग वी कैन गेस वी कैन अज्यूम दैट बाय द टाइम हर फ्लाइट लैंड्स, जब तक उसकी फ्लाइट लैंड करेगी एयरपोर्ट पे, सो टिल देन पॉलिना विल हैव रेड द मैगजीन. सो दिस एक्शन ऑफ रीडिंग द कम्प्लीट मैगजीन वुड बी ओवर. The athlete dash his own record by the time he appears in his last Olympics. So the athlete will have broken, break, broke and broken. The competition will have commenced. Commence means start by next fortnight. Okay, this is the future time till when this action would have been done, action of commencing. Rajan dash his training after 6 months. So Rajan will have completed his training. And Deepa will have visited her aunt during the Diwali days. And by the time the guests arrive, my mother will have made. Make sure we have to use V3 form of make, and that is make, made and made. So V1, V2, V3. Make is V1. Made is V2 and V3 is also made. Okay, so don't write maked and all. Many students I have seen, they are writing maked, but it is made. Next is, and the last of this exercise, Jack will have played soccer in the team by next year. Okay, so by the end of the by next year, this action of Jack's action of playing soccer would have been over. Now let us understand future perfect continuous. Here we are taking the combination of both perfect and continuous tense. So the future perfect continuous tense, future perfect tense talks about the action that began in the past and is continuing in the present and will get over by a specific time in the future. So for example, by this time tomorrow, we will have been traveling for 36 ours. So this is very important for you to understand this. Dekho, if you want to say that I have been traveling for last 2 hours, that means that the action started in the past and it is still going on in the present while speaking, and it will be continued for some time in the future. But when we are just talking about the actions which will start also in future, and when we will speak, that moment also will be future, and after that also for some time period it will be going on. So for such situation we have to use future perfect continuous tense. So as I said that I have been traveling, so that means that have been traveling means present perfect continuous tense. So usme kya hota hai, hum present mein bol rahe hote, but yahan pe has ki jagah will have hai, so it is for future tense. So by this time tomorrow, so यहाँ पे क्या है कि कल इतने बजे तक क्या हो जाएगा, वी विल हैव बीन ट्रैवलिंग फॉर 36 आवर्स. सो एट दिस टाइम टुमोरो वी विल हैव कंप्लीटेड 36 आवर्स ऑफ ट्रैवलिंग. सो ऐसे तो 24 आवर्स होते हैं. सो पास्ट में एक्शन स्टार्ट हुई थी और फ्यूचर में इस टाइम पे हम अगर बोले ये सेंटेंस, तो ये एक्शन चालू है और कुछ और घंटे जर्नी आगे चालू रहने वाली है. सो दैट्स व्हाई फ्यूचर परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस, यानी कि कंप्लीट कब होगा, फ्यूचर में, और फ्यूचर में थोड़ा बहुत कंटिन्यू भी रहने वाला है. ओके, इन द अबो सेंटेंस द एक्शन ऑफ ट्रैवलिंग बिगेन सम टाइम अगो इन द पास्ट, is going on in the present and will get over the next day. Present means आज का present नहीं, tomorrow, by this time tomorrow. Okay, ये present की बात करें, it is little bit confusing. So just make it very clear. So on the basis of this we have to solve this exercise. Convert these sentences into future perfect continuous tense. Don't forget to add a definite time such as 4-10 years, 4 hours and so on. So next year by this time I'll be working here. So next year by this time will be working will be replaced with I will have been working here for 2 years. Okay, specific time we need to add. At 5 p.m. I'll be studying. So you can say at 5 p.m. I will have been studying for half an hour or for 2 hours. Tomorrow by this time I'll be flying. So tomorrow by this time I will have been flying for 10 hours. Okay, you can just add the time duration as per the situation given in the sentence. Coming June I'll be learning music. So coming June I'll be learning music for 5 months. In 2020 I'll be playing for the national cricket team. So in 2020 I'll have been playing for the national cricket team for 6 months. All right, so we have to choose the time period, whether it should be in hours or in minutes or months or years. Okay, that depends on the given sentence. All right, so in today's video we will learn this much. The next video we will cover up the remaining part of this chapter. Thank you.